everyone. I hope you all are fine, safe and healthy at your home. So let us start our today's session. In our today's session, we will study about the pH, pH scale and the need of the pH scale. So first of all, you have to understand why do we need the pH scale. So here an indicator is used. pH, it is an indicator. It is used to test whether an aqueous solution is acidic, alkaline or the neutral. Okay, so alkaline substances are the water soluble bases. Okay, so to identify the specific solution, either it is acidic, basic or the neutral, we need the pH scale. Okay, so pH, it is the power of hydrogen ion concentration, that we must know that. Here P stands for power. Actually this is the potence. Potence means the power. Actually P stands for potence. P means potence and it stands for power. Okay, it means power. Okay, mathematically it is negative logarithm of hydrogen ion concentration. So how it is to be written as pH is equals to negative logarithm H plus ion. As we have to find out POH, so negative logarithm OH ion concentration we have to use it. But here you have to understand in today's lecture the pH, that is equal to negative logarithm H plus ion concentration. Its related numericals we will solve in the next lecture. Okay, so let us see here pH scale. pH scale, that was made by, especially we can say that was given by Sorensen. Actually what he did, he designed the pH scale in 14 equal parts. The center of the scale is 7. It represents the solution is neutral. The number 7, if the value 7 comes, it shows that the solution will be neutral. If the value comes less than 7, it represents the solution is acidic. While the value is getting greater than 7, it represents the solution is basic. Okay, so here you see, here I have made a pH scale for you. So here values starts from 0 and reached up to the 14. Number 7 shows that the solution is neutral, and if its value is going to be lesser than 7, that means this is acidic, and if it is going to be more than 7, that means solution is basic. Here I'm just telling the color change also. Whenever the solution value of pH starts to decrease, the color changes to first orange, then more lesser, then pink color arises, then red color, and at last you can say maroon or the dark red in the least pH value. Okay, as the pH value increases, the color of the solution, here in the neutral the color of the solution is green, and here now it becomes dark green. Now or in on increasing more, it becomes blue, and on the highest value it becomes violet in the color. Okay, so here I have written few points for you that will be easy to understand. If pH value is getting equal to 7, solution is neutral. If it is greater than 7, this is basic. If it is lesser than 7, it is acidic. Okay, so here you have to understand these two more important points. Addition of alkali will increase the pH of neutral solution. Here you have to understand what is alkali. Alkali, these are water soluble bases. The specifically we use that word water soluble bases for the alkali. Okay, so if we are adding some alkalis, means the water soluble bases, the pH value will increase of the neutral solution. If we are adding acid, so pH value starts to decrease. Okay, pH value starts to decrease on adding acid in a neutral solution, and pH value starts to increase on adding base in a neutral solution. Okay, so these are the points that you have to know that. So here simply you can say pH is inversely proportional to acidic value. Okay, pH value will decrease on adding acidic solution. Okay, and pH value will increase on adding basic solution. So that was a little bit introduction which I have shared with you about the pH, pH scale and the pH values, and its related numerical problems will be discussed in the next session. I hope you all have got it properly. That's all.